Game engines are only for games, right? Well, you might be surprised that the first thing I'm making with my game engine isn't a game at all. Let me explain. You might have seen this window in my previous videos. That's the editor for my game engine. A beautiful interface using I'm GUI, and most importantly, running on the game engine core. As it turns out, game engines can make more than just games. I haven't realized it at first, but it makes so much sense. Let's take a look at how it works. The most basic look at the structure is like this. On top is the engine core, which then is used by both the game and the editor, and then the editor takes in the game. This allows us to very easily share functionality between the game and the editor. By the way, that's how we can play the game from the editor in my implementation. Since the editor can do anything the game can, we can simply just play the game within the editor itself. As I was looking at the features of the engine core, I realized that most of it can be used within the editor. If I figure out how to actually use the core properly within the editor, making the game will be much easier since I'll know what it's capable of. Now, you might think that there's no way I can actually utilize all of the features from the game engine in the editor. And you're right, we'll probably use just the core part of the game engine. I don't think I have ever revealed the whole feature set of the engine core yet. Well, it's because it's all in progress. Nothing is set in stone, and from week to week many things change. But I'll give you a sneak peek. Let's go feature by feature and explain how we can utilize it within the editor. Firstly, our little ECS, my beloved. This is still one of my favorite things I ever programmed. ECS is great for managing in-game entities and their data, and it'll do that within the editor too. Sometimes you want something specific within the editor, like a gizmo or something like debug point somewhere. So our editor will have its own ECS. I'll talk more about it in a later video, as we talk about how the editor and the game coexist together in the editor app. One of the obvious ones are events. Great for decoupling, great for managing functionality, and they will be great when we want to do something within the editor, like click a button. Shared data. This is one of the more interesting features. I wanted to write something like dependency injection from .NET, where you have a store of classes and when you request them anywhere from the constructor, they appear. You can use their data or functionality or something like that. Since the engine is structs with data only and simple functions, our shared data will keep a hold of structs that are shared across the application. Is it basically fancy singletons? Tell me in the comments what you think. Also, we have a specific store for shared data query, where we cache queries by their definition. Now, of course, the editor will need some queries of its own to process and manage entities, so that will be useful. Then there are assets. An editor will definitely need its own assets for debug shapes or specific icons or textures. Lastly, we'll need some way to render within the editor and render the editor itself, so we'll use the graphics functionality from the engine core, otherwise there'd be nothing to see. We can see that the core features of the game engine are useful, not just for building games, but also like normal apps. In the end, maybe it makes sense, but I wonder how much of the core engine functionality do the editors usually use? But it's fun to think about the fact that the first thing built with my game engine isn't actually a game at all. And this is just the beginning. If you'd like to follow my journey of discovering how game engines work, subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time, where we discuss how we can run the game inside the editor.